North Carolina's estuaries are some of the largest in the world, covering over 3,000 square miles. These shallow and broad expanses of water are unique economic and natural resources. Scientists and researchers at the UNC Coastal Studies Institute are studying these estuarine ecosystems and our interactions with them.
I'm Mike Peeler. I'm the program head in estuarine ecology and human health at the Coastal Studies Institute. I have a joint appointment as an assistant professor at the UNC Chapel Hill Institute of Marine Sciences. An estuary is the place where the land and the water intersect on their way to the ocean. Watersheds drain to rivers, rivers transport materials in the water to the coast, and when the rivers meet the coast, they begin to widen out. And in this area where they widen out and begin to interact with salt water is an estuary. Estuaries are definitely not homogeneous. People think of them as one thing, but if you look through the estuarine gradient, there are multiple habitat types. The most obvious difference is water depth, but the depth of water determines the way that the system functions. If you have very shallow water, you can have photosynthesis on the bottom. If you have deeper water, you only have photosynthesis in the water column. Along the fringes of estuaries, such as one where we're standing now, are lots of different habitats, including marshes. As you get farther down into the salty areas, you have seagrasses, and you also have oyster reefs. It's important to study estuaries for several reasons. First and foremost, they're a really important area for productivity and processing of materials in aquatic systems in general. To understand what's going on in an estuary is essential to understand the connection between the land and the water. So if we don't study these processes and see how they're working, we won't know the things that they are doing that may be of value to us, and we also won't know the processes that were occurring that may be lost as humans continue to affect the landscape. We've been doing a whole lot of work on oysters. They are important in ecosystem function in that they clean the water column and they transport materials from the water into the sediments, which changes the way that a system functions. In transporting material from the water to the sediments, they also change the way that nutrient cycling occurs in sediments. There has been a lot of faith put in oysters to help enhance water quality, and oyster restoration is being employed as a tool in many systems in which they're trying to enhance water quality and combat the effects of eutrophication. We're really interested in the specific processes that oysters stimulate in the sediments. Rather than just think that the material that goes from the water column to the sediments is lost, we like to know the exact fate of that material. And that involves some pretty involved experiments assessing specific processes such as denitrification. Oysters, as they couple the water column and the sediments, enhance organic matter, they change the quality of the organic matter, and they concentrate a lot of the materials from the water column to the sediments, making the sediments then a hot spot of different processes. We've done a lot of work comparing sediments with and without oysters present and have found that oysters do in fact, through their activity of filtering and through their role just as structure up in the water column, enhance the process of denitrification significantly. And this is an important thing to understand and know because removing nitrogen from a system is something that people want to happen and that people pay a great deal of money to have happen through systems like sewage treatment plants and stormwater treatment structures. So this service that the oysters are doing, removing nitrogen, is of significant value to people. We're really interested in understanding how this process occurs and where it occurs. And where it occurs is very important because there are certain places within the estuary, namely farther upstream, where it may be more important to remove nutrients. So knowing whether or not the oyster enhancement of denitrification occurs throughout the estuary and particularly occurs in areas where the nutrient removal is of most value is critically important. If there's a mismatch between where oysters are enhancing nitrogen removal and where the nitrogen removal is most valuable, that'll affect the degree to which it benefits people.